Hi everyone, great to see you here today. Thanks for joining us for Webinar Wednesday. Today, Michael Ward will be presenting about breaks and master detail features for this web intelligence webinar, and we really appreciate that you're here with us today. I know this is probably lunchtime for a lot of people, so thank you so much for being here. And we'll go ahead and get started in just a moment. I just wanted to let you know that this session is being recorded and we'll put this up on our YouTube channel. It will also be on our website at library/videos. And we'll be emailing you the URL after. Just to let you know a little bit about Accelebrate, we've been in business for 19 years and we deliver a lot of private customized training all over the US and worldwide. And now, of course, online. And actually the really cool thing about online is we can do half day classes now. So if you can't commit to a full day being away from your desk, actually Michael's been really flexible with doing half day classes. And just to let you know about other topics that we teach other than Webby, we do teach programming languages, data science, data visualization like Power BI and Tableau, JavaScript libraries like React and Angular, and a lot more. But today it's all about business objects, Webby. And if you're interested in customized private training for your team of three or more, you can get in touch with us at accelebrate.com. These classes can also be half day classes, and Michael Ward is the instructor. And with the classes, you get some of his wonderful materials like the 40 best practices guide, the master list of 80 new features, his class materials, and more. And the good news is we're also doing a special sort of pop-up open enrollment advanced Webby training. This is because people asked for it. We were going to be running it in the fall, but a lot of people just kind of needed it now. So it is running July 20th to the 21st. And you can also sign up for that on our website. So this is just if you have one or two people to train and you don't have a whole team. But whether or not you do the private three or more or for individuals, Michael Ward is our instructor and he is our go-to trainer for all things web intelligence. He's got many years of experience, over 23 years with business object tools. He presents all over the US and the world, and he does these wonderful webinars for us. So let me go ahead and turn this over to Michael so he can start presenting for you. And here we go.
Okay,
so, Michael, you should have the power.
Yeah, so it should have me up on the screen now. You should be seeing me.
I see, your contact info, yep.
Yep, so there we go. Just a quick reference, point of reference for you all. Here's my email address in case you have any questions or whatever, in case you're interested in, you know, questions about the training. Everything I continue to do is version 4.2. We have 4.3 training already out. It follows the same general format as 4.2. It's a little early for you to consider, other than if you were setting up a sandbox. And if you are going to do it, you better plan for like a 6-month window to break people in, because it's there's some nice similarities, but there's some significant differences. They've done some pretty cool stuff. But navigating around, you don't want to waste hours and days when with just a little bit of training and some good content, you can quickly get up to speed with the product. They've done some amazing things. There's more coming with it. I work directly with the Paris developers, so I get a lot of documentation and whatever as well. But where the production release for 4.3 SP2 won't be available till early next year at this point. That was going to be the big production one. You'd want to wait till then, unless you set it up in a sandbox environment and play with it there as well. So just some quick information. So what we're going to do today, let's have some fun. You know, I like to make these exciting to give you some really good content, some real life stuff. It's going to be breaks versus master detail. Okay, breaks versus master detail. A lot of us are used to putting breaks in a report. A lot of you might not be familiar with master detail. If you've been through some of my training, you might remember I do some really incredible stuff in the intermediate course with master detail or section reports. Okay, so it really makes it nice now that you have some flexibility. But most people don't realize what advantage does one have over the other. So we're going to talk about breaks, managing breaks, some of the advanced features. Then we're going to create a master detail report or a section report. And I'm going to bounce between my two report tabs and kind of go back and forth and show you. There's some pretty cool stuff unique to one or the other, some things that both can do, just a matter of managing those along the way as well. So there's a feature comparison at the end I can always close with later on. So let me get into Webby real quick here. I got to remember, I'm in 4.2, not in 4.3, because I've been doing a lot of 4.3 related stuff, especially with enhancing materials and stuff like that. So I'm in 4.2 though, good release to be in for a while. So we're going to build the report right up front. And so let me get into Webby. Here's our standard BI launch pad, as you're all familiar with. A little different look with 4.3, but 4.2, pretty straightforward. We'll hit our new button over here, as we always do when we're creating something new. We will pick Universe, Notice, Excel, Text, Freehand SQL, all different options that are available. In fact, in the advanced class coming up, we do Universes and Excel, and we show you examples of how to bring in Freehand SQL as multiple data providers within a single document. So the neat things that you can do. The product continues to grow and power that way. And I'll pick the old boring e-fashion that we're all used to seeing. And there's our query panel. So let's line up nice report, build our query, get the objects that we need so we don't have to go back to the query panel. It's nice that it allows us to do that, but we don't want to have to do that. Year, quarter, we'll do state. For any of my Canadian friends out there, I know some of you I did some training for are out there. We could envision them being provinces instead, which works fine. And I want to get rid of margin and discount. Notice when I double clicked on a folder, the entire contents of the folder are automatically deposited into the results objects window, and I took them out as well. So simple query, we'll run the query, let it rip from there. And let's start talking about making the report more readable, enhancing it. Most all of you are probably already familiar with breaks, maybe not with master detail reporting, so that's part of the reason for this, to kind of give you an opportunity to see what you can do. So we have a report laid out, and it's got year, quarter, state, and some measures. As you know, it's done alphabetically, starting with your leftmost column, and then the next one inside of that, and the next one inside of that. And as you all know, from the analysis tab on top, you have the ability to sort. You could do breaks. You could do local functions like sum, count, whatever. And of course, you can do filtering and so on. A lot of functionality. I've covered those in a lot of the other webinars, like the analysis tab, your best friend, and things like that. So let's make this a little more readable. Why don't we highlight the year column, and why don't we do a break, all right? And it automatically breaks it. And lo and behold, there we go. And if you look on the leftmost column, you see my year columns there. I'm waiting for it to give me control back here. There's my year, quarter, state, sales revenue, quantity sold. So if I want to scroll down here, here we go. They scroll down from the top, you can see it very clearly. Let me use my little scroll bar on the right here to move it up and down. So it's got 2018, okay, and at the end of the year, 2018, notice something brand new. This is something you get automatically with a break that you do not get with a master detail report. You get automatic subtotals whenever you put a break anywhere. That's a 4.2 Service Pack 6 enhancement. Your company or organization should be at SP7 to really take advantage of even more interesting things as well. For that one, but I decided I wanted a second level break. We're just gonna do a quick example of that to show you, okay? Then we'll take it out and we'll simplify it a little bit just for the sake of some of the examples we're gonna do later on. So now I have a secondary break within the first. So at the end of each quarter, I get a subtotal. Then at the intermediate level, which is the year, I get at the end of the fourth quarter, I get the year intermediate total for each one. And one thing you don't get, very important, again, something different from breaks versus master detail. The very bottom of the report, I don't get grand totals. Okay, I need to actually hit my page number here because it's a little bit longer to go down a little bit further. And it doesn't give you automatic grand totals with the new feature. So what I'm gonna do, again, is I'm gonna go to Format Table, look for the four-way arrow along the edge of the report block. When you see it, I could get my new mouse, and I'm still fighting with this new one. If I go to Format Table, okay, there's an option called Table Footers. That's the new way as of SP6 and above to get a grand total only, okay? And at the very bottom of the report, I get my overall grand total. There it is, okay, for those. Let's see if I can get the auto fit to work. Sometimes it can be finicky if you're trying to move your mouse around, get it just right. Widen it up a little bit. Hopefully we'll see all the values as well. So that's something unique, okay? So we were able to lay it all out in a nice, neat format. Let me go back to the top again. And you saw where we had multiple breaks, okay? You can manage breaks very effectively. Let's talk about that, because we're gonna also do a comparison to managing your sections, section reports as well. So for breaks, it tells me it's blue because it's on. I'm going to do a sort, do a descending sort. Let's take advantage of all the awesome features that are on the analysis tab. So we've got a sort applied as well. Okay. There's my year. Since I've got year highlighted, I can go into manage breaks, and we have an awesome feature unique to breaks called manage breaks. We don't have manage breaks with master detail, as we're going to see in a couple of minutes. We have format section instead. So a little different way of looking at it. And for each and every one of my breaks, notice because I have more than one, when I go to manage breaks, it does show those to me in hierarchical order that I turned them on. Okay, it's got a header turned off for that one, but for quarter, if you look at quarter, it's got it both turned on there, and you've got the various properties back and forth. A value-based break, I can make it do a break only on certain conditions. The centering of the values in between was the duplicates first versus a merge that I could do on that one as well. Some things standard to come with it. Big one, start on a new page. Okay. That's a reason enough to go to manage breaks, is because you've set up a higher level break. We have multi-level actually. And on the very highest level, I want to force a break. There you go. All built in, very nice and neat for us as well. Okay. We're going to simplify this a little bit. So I'm going to get rid of the break on quarter and then get rid of that. It'll make it a little easier for some of the examples we're going to do when we go back and forth. And as you know, I can drag it out. If you're in Chrome, it's going to be an up and over. And if IE, we can drag it straight out and take the column out directly itself as well. Okay. So there we go. So now let's talk about a master detail. Let's use the speed menu in the bottom. Let's do an add report. And in the add report window, we're going to do a year, state. Let's do year, state, sales revenue, quantity sold. We'll drag it all out to there. And there's my new report block automatically generated for me there. And what I want to do here is, instead of making it a break, what I want to do is I want to make it a section report, a master detail report. Think of a master detail as like taking one of your break levels. Instead of making it a column, you're making it a master cell that sits above the block. So in this particular case, what we would like to do, maybe we want to do it for each of the years, or we could do it for each of the states, depending which way you want to look at it. Let's do it for years, since the first report is based on years. And if I want, I can take my year, I can pull it out. This is how you, one way of creating a master detail, and I can drop it into place. And you need to be careful. You got to allow a space for a title. Since I added a new report tab, I didn't get a title generated. I'm going to have to add it in. There's a page header at the top that I could overflow if I'm not careful. And when you create master cells, you got to be careful where you put them, because they're a little bit finicky about being moved. Because I pulled the year out of it, what it did was it took year out of the block and it made it a master cell. Okay. Other ways you could do that. Let me undo that. Again, this unique to master detail reports or sectioning only. Let me get it out again, undo it, because you have your unlimited undos to put it back into the report. Another way I could have done that, which I don't recommend, is using your right click shortcut menu, the big one that comes up. You're in the right place. And there's also a set as section here. I don't like the set as section because it decides where to put it over here, and it usually wastes a bunch of space, and then I got to delicately try to move the sections up or down and around. So it creates a little bit of extra work for it as well. Okay. Another way you could have done it is if you didn't have the year already in the report. Let's take that one out. Let's assume a report looked like this. Whoop, I thought I had it. And I take it out. And I decided to go up to the report elements option up here. And when you go to report elements, you know you got to be cautious, be careful. These are all assumed to be empty blocks that you're depositing. And then the object's got to be done, filled in on top of that later on by dragging in certain cases or using assigned data. Okay. Well, there's one for section. And if I click insert a section, this is for new. Remember the old piece of gum stuck to your shoe syndrome? It's right here. It brings that one up. Let me get rid of my stupid email thing that's dropping in. We don't need to have that out there, any of us, for that. And it says, what do you want to create the master cell based on? I want it to be based on year. Okay. And it automatically puts the year in there, 18, 19, 20, and 21. We did that way instead. And I had a little bit of control over where it was positioned. We'll leave it right there. Okay. So this is a master detail report. If we go to report number one, it's just a plain old vertical table with breaks on it. Well, what can we do with report number two? What are some additional bonuses that we have? Why don't we get totals for sales revenue quantity sold? We didn't get them automatically because we didn't do a break, and we're in a master detail block. So we're looking at a different type of structure. We're going to move this up a little bit so it tightens up things for viewing for us as well. Okay. But what I could do is I could go in and I could take the sales revenue and your classic from your analysis tab on top. We have our classic way of doing, I got to jump over there. I can do my sum. And I can take the quantity sold and I can do a sum on that one as well. And I could put them in myself. Okay. With the auto break, remember when I did the break, it automatically subtotaled all measures. Okay. It didn't do that here because it's not a break. And I have to do each individual column myself in order to make this work. So there's little things like that you have to watch out for. So I've got my year sitting out here, 18, 19, 20, 21. Okay, scrolling up and down. Okay. And let's go back here. Let me just click out of here. Get to put it back in there. And again, let me move it around just a little bit more to the right for that sake. And then we've got a little bit more room for it as well. Okay. So it's a different way of representing the data. Well, with the year, when I had the break on year, I got subtotals at the end of each one, which were these right here. But because it's a master detail block, it has a master section of detail, I can do it a different way. I can deposit the subtotals on top in addition to being on the bottom. How do I do that? Well, the first thing we got to do is make sure that whenever we create one or more master cells, because I can have more than one, we're only going to stick to one here, but I could have more than one, okay? I like to format it, I like to border it, because I want to know how big my master cell values are, okay? So classic stuff, it's down here, let's put a medium thick border around it, okay? And now I can see where each of my master blocks comes out. There's 18, 19, 20, 21. Remember how we sorted the years on the previous example? I can do the same here. It doesn't matter that it's a master cell, I can do this. I can go up to my sort on my analysis and I can say, you know what, let's do a descending sort. So in effect, I'm doing the same thing here, the master cell level that we did with our normal break here by just sorting on the column itself. Very easy, very direct reference back and forth, easy to see, okay? So there they all are, but now what I want to be able to do is, since I've got the year up here, wouldn't it be nice if I could view the subtotals above the detail block that it represents? And I could still leave the subtotals out here, but I want to put it above. This is where you begin to see the difference between doing a break versus a master detail. What I can do here is I can drag from the left side sales revenue, drag it across, put it just to the right of the year. And by depositing it at the year level, it's called the section total. We're doing it at the master section, okay? It gets a little finicky moving it around and sizing it up, so you have to bear with me. That's just formatting things that you learn little tricks of the trade for using the paint feature and so on. So I know that that's my sales revenue total for the four that you see right there. And I can do quantity sold like this. But now I'm displaying them once again in the header section above the report, in addition to leaving it in the report block itself. And again, lining these up gets a little finicky, but you just got to get used to stretching them out and formatting and so on along the way. And if we wanted, we could drag that down a little bit and get it all lined up right. And there we go. And if I'm smart, what I can do is I can take the report that I have here, can line it up underneath it a little bit. So the columns kind of line up where here's my sales revenue, here's my quantity sold. And we can do a little sizing game with those as well. If you wanted to, you could put a blank cell up here in the header area and put sales revenue as a label and quantity sold as a label if you wanted. Those are all things that are available for you to do as well. So these are basically section totals. Over here on the reporting side, I don't really have that. All I have the ability to do is get the subtotals and the grand totals, or intermediates if there was a second level break, but I don't really have the ability to put them above, not that easily, as you see right here, what we did with the master detail, okay, with this one here, okay? So it makes it nice. I can perform all the standard functions off the analysis toolbar on here if I wanted to as well, but now I'm looking at it a little different way. One of a number of huge advantages that you get with a master detail report is you get a certain function over here, a little tab along the left edge of your window. There's different categories. This is one of your available objects and for input controls and so on. There's one here called the map tab or navigation map, which I've nicknamed the map tab. This is another plus for using a master detail report. So if I click on that one, it opens up a map tab for each tab. And for master detail reports, it actually creates a hierarchical tree. Now, I only have year, but if I had year quarter, both with breaks, or a quarter underneath year in a master, where I had two master cells and the detail underneath it, let's say maybe at the state level, okay, I would have a two level. But it's used for navigating, and you can click around and you can go to whatever one you want. It's a much better example if you would have a lot more detail with it. Okay, we've got it down to just year, which had four. If I had done state, we would add an eight. But I want this report, master detail, to map directly back to this report, which is driven off of year, state, in the same kind of order, okay? So you get this map tab for navigation purposes, which you don't get with a regular report your typical vertical table or cross table, whatever. You don't get that. It's not available. Okay. But the navigation map does come along for the ride. If I export this to PDF, guess what? The navigation map gets carried across as a bookmark. So now you've provided a tool for your users to allow them to be able to navigate through. You know, what if I had 50 states in there? Okay. And I was doing it by state, maybe in year instead, to find directly any one of those 50 states, I could automatically use the navigation map on the left side to find it. And isn't it nice knowing it carries it over to PDF? And before somebody asks, you can't do it for Excel, only for PDF, unfortunately, but that's just how that works. That is an amazing feature. I've had many people create reports. Instead of doing a break at the highest level, they make it a master cell. They put the section totals in, just like we see right here. And at the detail level is the rest of the report. But they did it because they wanted that bonus feature, the navigation map, for people to find things. You know, if you're an organization where you have 300 or 400 branches, you know, or offices, okay, and you could, this could be the master cell, could be each branch. You've got 300 or 400 of them. Are you going to honestly want to use the scroll bar on the right side and the page numbers in the bottom to find something mid-range? Could, you know, around 150, could take forever for that, okay? So some other nice things that Master Detail give you the ability to do, it would be very difficult to do on the report side over here, is what if I decided I wanted to have a chart, and I wanted the chart to show me the data, some of the data that we see here. In this particular case, I want to be able to create a pie chart of my state data, okay? What I can do with a Master Detail, and of course, the regular vertical table doesn't allow it, is this. Let's do a right-click copy. And we're going to do a right-click paste over on the right here. We just duplicated the block, okay? Now we're going to say, well, you know what? Let's do a good old turn into. You're going to be moving to 4.3. Turn into is a major player in the new 4.3 release. You do a lot more with it. I'm just going to pick pie chart blind. I know what it does, so I'm going to take a chance on it. And the charting engine takes a little bit longer to come up initially because it's a brand new thing that came out, the 4.1, 4.4.2 with upgrades and so on along the way. So wait for it to come up. Sometimes I force it along when I do a refresh on it, but we'll see if that will do it or not. Give it a minute or two to come up. And it will eventually pop up there and you'll see what happens. Sometimes it kind of drives the engine a little bit more to make it run a little faster for that one. But what I wanted to do is I'd like to have a pie chart version on the right side of the report on the left side, but at the detail level, not the summary level. By doing it in the detailed section, it automatically replicates that and bounces it all the way through, all the way through. All right, come on, refresh it enough, bring it back up. It will in a minute. And any other charting that I do will then automatically show later for that one. It's a little bonus I thought I'd throw in for the chart piece of it. I'm going to show you another feature instead of that where we're going to remove it and do something different as well that is unique to Master Detail that wouldn't necessarily work for the standard vertical table like we did. So give it a minute or two to catch up. While we do that, let's see if we can take a couple questions there. And we have any questions initially while I'm waiting for that? We might as well try to knock off a few of those.
Yeah, let me take a look. No, you are doing such a good job, Michael. Nobody has a question.
Oh, okay. Well, that's good news.
But I'll continue that on her. Yeah, there's a little panel on there. If anyone has questions, you can go ahead and type it in there. We sometimes wait until the end, but if there's a stopping point, we'll try.
Yeah, we'll let her run. It's just taking a little longer the first time. Probably should have started up one with charting already, so the engine had fired up. So it'll take a minute or two. And what's going to happen is we're going to see a pie chart on the right with the report on the left. But what's interesting about it, because it's in the detail section of a master detail report, it replicates it in every detail section. So for every year, I'm going to have the state report on the left, the pie chart on the right representing the same data in chart format, and I can look at it visually that way. And those could be linked. One of the things we do in advanced reporting classes, we show you how to link blocks together, maybe a pie chart linked to reports, create basic dashboarding functionality, and does some pretty cool things as well. Come on, guys, run it through. Sometimes if I cancel, it'll accelerate it as well. Just waiting for it to kick in. It always comes up slow on that one for whatever reason. And over on the, here we go. It's coming back right now. We'll get it to pop up. That's thinking about it. And there we go. Nice, colorful. The charts are much more robust as a 4.2 service pack 6. Okay. I'm getting really good. Uh-oh, didn't like something that I clobbered on that chart. Yeah, that didn't help me any for that one. If it didn't clobber me permanently, it shouldn't have. Sometimes it will when the charting kicks like that. Yeah, it did. I'll go back to my available objects here. Got those are still there for me. Let me do another refresh, see if it'll repopulate. I think they drove the charting engine nuts. They drove it crazy in the process. So we did see it come up and got to witness it for a second. Sometimes it's finicky about allowing you to move it as well. So we'll get it to come back up again. And we'll let it rock and roll. And the first tab had the report with just the breaks. The second was the master detail section that we see right here as well. So come on, refresh it. Bring it back up for me, guys. If I got to regenerate, it's no big deal. I'm pretty good at doing these very, very fast from training and presentations and the like for that one. So we'll see what it's going to do. Didn't like me interrupting it, I think was what it was. So I'll give it another minute or two, then I'll just do a quick rebuild on it, which I do as part of the exercise anyways for you, just to show you. Since you're about to clear it out, yeah, let's clear it. I don't like what it did. So we'll just throw that out. We'll come back in. And we'll rebuild again from there. So it'll be a nice little review section here. So let's go back home. Let's click the old Webby icon. We'll rock and roll here. It won't take but a minute. Well, we're going to regenerate. Easy enough. That's what I like about this. It's easy to create a master detail where you've already created a vertical table or whatever pretty easily. Got some additional features I wanted to show you. You got to see how the chart worked in there. I want to do an example without the chart with something else that you'll like. So I brought over year, and I brought over state, and I'll bring over the measures, get them all, minus two. There's a new feature in 4.3 that allows you to just to delete these directly, which is pretty cool, but I like to drag them out. So we're just going to rerun it, take the existing report, we'll throw in breaks on one, we'll create a quick master detail, and then we'll show you some additional enhancements as well, some other cool features that come in. Wait for it to come back up. So we'll have our standard vertical table, which we'll throw in a break like we did. We'll create the section report right out of it pretty easily for that one. And here it comes. And here comes my report. And there we go. So we'll take, I'm going to reverse this. I'm going to do the example in a little different order now, more consistent with the way I like to do things. Here's our drag and drop to switch the order of them around. We'll take the state level and we'll turn it in with a break off of the analysis. There's your good buddy, the break, the analysis tab with the break. Okay. And then we'll add another report tab over to this side. We'll regenerate the master detail. We'll show you some other slick things that you can do as well. Okay. There's report tab number one. We'll have to redisplay the data. And then we'll go to report tab number two. And let me delete that one out of there. It should be blank. So what I'm going to do is a state. So we'll do this. We'll build a simple one over here, right here. What we'll do is we'll take state and year. Actually, I'll do it as a multi-select. I like that better. And sales revenue and quantity sold. We'll drag all those out onto our report block there to create it. And what we'll do is we'll create a master detail of it. But I flipped it around for state instead of year, which lends itself a little better. We pull it out very carefully. We create our master cell. Okay, take the detail report, drag it up a little bit. For the master cell, I always talked about doing formatting, putting the border around it. It's a very good thing to do. So we'll do a border, medium thick border around it. There we go, easy enough to generate. And then if I want, I can take my sales revenue value. Whoop, gotta do one at a time. And I can create my master section totals, or section total is the name that they use for it. which puts my quantities or my sales revenue out there first. Look how easy that was. Just had to regenerate real quick, but look how easy, using all the drag and drop and multi-selecting capability, we're taking advantage of the product, making it easy for us to put out there. And we'll put our quantity sold to the right of that. Let's stick that right over here, but not on top of the sales revenue, but right next door. It's easy to mess that one up if you're not careful. Okay. If you want a real quick trip on aligning master cells, there is a little trick for that one. It's not super great, but if I were to multi-select all three cells going across using the controller shift. Okay. So I'm going across, a right click format or alignment takes you to a formatting area where you can align them top, middle, or bottom. And we'll align them in the middle, kind of balance them out. And lo and behold, there we go. All right. So another nice advantage to having master detail, of course, we can have our sales revenue subtotals. Remember we had those? We did it automatically when we did it on it with a break, but we have to do those ourselves because there's no break on this report at the detail level. This is the master section area. This is the detailed section area here. That's the reference point we do for them. All right. Now, if you remember with reports on this side, what else did we have? Well, if I highlight state, you'll notice the breaks lights up very nicely. And if I go to manage breaks, look at all the options they have available to us here. Turn the header off, turn the footer off, don't do the sort on them, start on a new page for page breaks. Well, wait a minute. Do I lose that when I go to a master detail? And the answer is no, you don't. What I can do here instead is if I click over to the right area of state, you'll see a blue line appear. And if there's more than one master cell, you have to be very careful which one you click to the right of to make sure that the blue line is on top of the one that's current. I only have one, so I can't go wrong. And with a right click of your mouse, we're going to introduce another feature called format section. We have manage breaks, we have format section, kind of like sister brother. Format section comes up and says, okay, what do you want to do? Well, here's your general layout. You can actually hide sections. I'll show you that one a little bit later on. We can go to the appearance tab and we can go to the layout tab. And on the layout page, I can say start on a new page if I wanted to. And at that point, every single state will kick up a new page. So I have that feature for manage breaks. I have it in format section as well. Another really cool thing that I like about creating a master detail report is you have the ability to conditionally hide blocks at the detail level. And what do I mean by that? And this you can't do on the break side. If you notice for each state, 9.1 million, 2.5 million, if you look all the way down the line at all the section totals for each state, all the sales revenue values are less than 9 million except for three of them. And those three would be New York, Texas, and California. They all have a value over 9 million. Well, I'm building the report saying, you know what, if I give this to my users, they're going to look at it and say, why did you bother showing me those three good states? I know California, Texas, and New York are doing good. I don't want to see those. I want to see everybody else. Well, you have the ability to hide the detail report very nicely. And this is, again, an advantage to having a section report or a master detail section report. If I right-click along the edge of the entire block, because this is format table, right? Not individual column, format table. And the format table with the general and border and appearance and layout comes up. And there's a hide option that's available. And you can say hide when the following is true. And I can use the formula assist, the FX, which introduces the back doorway to our formula editor. And I can say if sales revenue is greater than 9 million, 9, 1, 2, 3, and a 1, 2, 3. So if it's greater than 9 million, okay, I'm going to hide it. And here's what you end up with. You don't waste your time looking at stuff that you don't need, okay? So look at what happened. California only shows the section total. It doesn't have the detail underneath it. And if I could have done the same thing if I had a chart next to it, exactly the same thing, format chart provides the same hide logic. And look at this. So I'm seeing detail reports for the ones I need it for. Anybody less than 9 million, for anybody greater than 9 million, I don't need it. They're doing great. I want to just see the totals, but I don't want to see the detail, okay? So that makes it kind of nice. You could kind of simulate that if you use the outlining functionality over on the report side. If you were to do an outline on it, you can collapse some of the groups down to only show the subtotals, but it's a lot of detail work for you to do as well. Okay. And of course, if I want to turn that feature off, I'll have to go to one that already has something there. So I could go back to format table and say, well, let's go back out there. Okay. And let's uncheck it and let's put them back in and let's see what we got. So again, now we're beginning to see another advantage with a master detail. I can actually selectively hide in a much more logical way, the way that I look at it. Remember, I still have my navigation map out here. The navigation map will apply to the Pick It Up Guys. It'll apply to the second tab, not the first one, because as you'll see, because I only have a master detail in the second, on the second report tab. And there you go. One of the things that I like that's really cool about this is the ability to bring in other objects that you want to kind of insert to the right. I just showed you creating a chart of the report. What if I wanted to do this? What if I instead wanted to have a stoplight out here, maybe red or green? So instead of hiding it, if it's greater than 9 million, I like to see a green stoplight show up. And if it's less than 9 million, I want to see a red one, but at the detail level all the way down the line. Well, I can do that. I can do conditional formatting and build in some things. Let's do that. That's a real interesting example. And again, it really highlights, again, leaning more towards the master detail side, saying, well, it's got a little bit of an advantage, because there would be no real way to do this on the report number one that you have right here because of the way the breaks. You could do it on an individual row by row basis, but how could you do it on the right side? It treats it as one long contiguous block. So you really would not be able to do that same functionality that we do right here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to insert a cell over on the right, and the cell is going to hold an image. It's a PNG image. We took a JPEG and downsized it to PNG to make it fit. And here's what we need to do. I need to put a cell out there first to hold my stoplight. And we'll go to cell, and we'll go to blank, and we'll drop it in right about here. And then we'll stretch it all out, and we'll make it big, and it might be a nice place to hold a stoplight. What we've actually created a long time ago, and I make these available in our training classes when you request them, is we've brought in some really neat looking stoplights. We created a big size like that would fit into this, and a smaller size that would fit at the row level. So you could also do this on an individual row basis and have a red, yellow, or green stoplight there. So we're going to use this, and we're going to use conditional formatting as another way of taking advantage of the master detail report. One thing about conditional formatting you have to be aware of: if you have a blank cell or a blank row or column, you cannot have it active like I do right now. Or when you try to go up and do the conditional formatting on it, it won't let you create the rule. It gets stuck. So you just deselect. I can create any rule at any time under any set of conditions, and then I can turn it on after, which is what we're going to do here. So let's create a new rule. Oh, looks like it's going to give me some grief on it, huh? Yep. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to save it. Do a save as, just to save it real quick. What's happening is I'm running out of memory with all the stuff that I've done already. That will happen when you're defining rules. So what I like to do is to save it very quickly here. If I can get it to say, oh, I don't want to print it. I want to save it, guys. Come on. Save as. And when it comes up, we'll save it as demo. I'll just put in my reporting folder here. We'll call it demo, D-E-M-O. Stop, S-T-O-P, and I'll just save it reporting. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to close it and reopen it. Sometimes you have to do that. That's just a small memory issue that I've run into before. Let's see if it'll let me do it now. Sometimes by just saving it, we'll open it up. Nope. Yeah, so I'm going to have to close it, just reopen it. Sometimes you got to close all the way down to the browser level to clear the browser history. Consistent thing you can run in on occasion when you're putting in a blank cell column. So let's go back to reporting. And where's my demo stop right there? We'll do a right click modify to open it up in full modify, the full edit capabilities. And since I saved it, it's still got the blank cell sitting out there right here, but I don't want that active. Okay, I don't want that active at all. Click out just away from all that. Hopefully my analysis button will let me do my conditional formatting now and not make me go all the way out. There we go. We'll just call it stop or stoplight. We'll just call it stop light. And what I want to do is the following. When you create conditional formatting, you create a rule with multiple condition statements. And for this one, I want to say select an object, sales revenue greater than or equal to. We'll type in 9 million, 9123123. Okay, and if it is, we're going to go to the format button. And what we're going to do is we're going to go to background. We're going to do image from a file. It's very straightforward. I have a little thing I do in our training class with this one where you get an opportunity to work on something like this. And we're going to go browse. And I have a folder out there that's got stoplights in it. It usually remembers where it is when I do the browse here. So it should find it for me. always the same one that I go to for it. Yep, it's going right in. And I want to bring in, this is if it's greater than, so I want the green light regular, not small. Okay, so I'm going to upload it. You're going to love this. This is really cool. And the stoplights are good. You want to do some display fixing. If you go in here, you can do a stretch. We'll stretch it to full length of the window. Little tricks like that you want to learn. And that was greater than 9 million. If we add a second condition statement, this one would be sales revenue less than 9 million. And we'll do, instead of a greater than, we'll do a less than. And we'll type in our 9 again. Oop, off one. 9, 1, 2, 3, and a 1, 2, 3. We have to scroll the window. That's standard part of conditional formatting. We teach that in intermediate and advanced both. Give you the little tips and tricks to watch out for. And we'll go to background. In this case, I want to insert an image from a file, but I want the red stoplight, not the green. It does say edit because one's already in there. We're not really going to edit. We're just going to browse and add the second one in right here. It brings up my little list. And this one, I want the red light, but not the small, the red light regular. We'll upload that one and we'll do an okay on it. So now what's going to happen is for every section that I'm in, because I'm basing it on the total for the section, it's going to either have a red or a green stoplight. I could have done red, yellow, green, or other ones as well. Why is it not turned on yet? Well, we haven't activated it. So now what we got to do is click on the cell, go up to the rule. We don't create a new rule. We just select it and that turns it on. And look what you get. Really cool. And we got the mini size. We got a mini one that'll fit at the row level. So you could do these at the row level. So usually in our training, I'll make available stoplights if people want them. We went through great pains to get them downsized and nice and neat for you, but look how that is, much more graphical. I like it better than that pie chart we had. Now I could have had both, really made it interesting if I wanted. I could have had all of them in there. You had yellow and green, but we wanted to make it, you know, look nice that way as well, right? Other things you can do is you can also apply conditional formatting here. We could change the background to green or red. Again, an advantage to doing it with a master detail. It stands out a little bit more for that one as well, okay? So these are all different options that are available for that, as you can see with having a master detail. You get the map tab along the way that comes with it and so on, okay? So you can see the very big differences between the two, okay? That's one single large block with breaks in there and I could page break it. I can do the same thing here at the format section level. But if you think about it, when you do a format section, it's like manage breaks in a different way. By doing this type of a layout, you're stretching it out. And again, I could have had state, year, and had quarterly data. Often the example I do in our one class in intermediate, we show you that. We show you how to do stoplights, for example, as part of that as well. So there's a lot of additional possibilities of what you can do when you move it into this concept of a master detail or a section report. You can see by virtue of the whole terminology, section report, that it has its roots in Oracle. When Business Objects was founded in 1990, the five gentlemen had left Oracle and formed Business Objects out of Paris. And of course, master detail came along from the ride from Oracle reporting. So it's kind of where its roots are as well. So again, there's also a feature that if I wanted, I could put a banner in here that could have got streamed across the top. You've probably seen me do that in some of my other presentations as well. But I like the fact that I have two different ways of delivering the same data. Okay. Report number one, basically it's one contiguous. Of course, I could put the page breaks in. You can do certain things, but not at the level you can when you bring it into a master detail report. A lot of customers like this because it could be branch. You could have state and branch and have 20 or 30 branches within each state if you're a bank or a service organization of some kind. But and look at how nice it is bringing in things like the stoplight as well. You have the ability to go design structure mode when you build structures like this, and it'll give you the under the covers look. That's a structure only view, okay? That's what it looks like. You can't really see much going on, but that's a nice under the covers. If you created a situation where you hit where you did try to hide it and every single block got hidden and you have nothing showing up, how can you undo it? Well, you can use the undo button, or if you go to view structure, you'll see the structure mode come up and you can do your right click format table and you could remove the hide logic for that one as well. So let me bounce back to here. This is a good summary. So we saw a lot of information come up in your breaks. I want to jump down towards the tail end of it. Down a little bit further. There's some more advanced features in here that for a time I don't, but I have the ability to sort on subtotals. I could break, I could do a ranking on them as well, and they're just an extension of here, but that's a little bit further than what I wanted here. But here we go. Here's our layout of what we do with value-based breaks. That's a feature that was introduced new, kind of unique to that you wouldn't get if you're doing section reports as well. So I have a real nice content that substantiates all that we've gone through here as well. A lot of that, just to give you a little bit more specific. But we're right where I expected to be, right on schedule. I want to give you some time for a question and answer. If there's anything I need, might maybe change on the example or whatever. So let's open it up at this point and let's see what we got in questions. It looks like there's a couple I can see now that I'm switched over.
Yep, I see one too. And it looks like, can you hide the whole section if the revenue is greater than 9 million?
Yes, you can. That's a very good question. But let me point out an interesting undocumented feature. In the very first 4 release, when we developed our initial training at 4.1, migrated to 4.2. When I went to format section, okay, and I could hide when the following is true, and I could do it at the section level. What if I did it here right now? It would hide the entire section. All right, it worked initially. Now it doesn't work, it hides the whole thing. So if you want to do that, what you have to do is a local filter. You'll be clicking here, you go up to the analysis tab, use the local filter button, you would add a filter in and testing for that sales revenue value, and then you could use that. That's how you would do it with a filter. So you'd have to create a local filter to do that one. Works very well. But the format section used to work in the very first release in the 4.1 world, but now it hides the entire section. And I actually had to talk to Samuel Polachek, the developer, on that at one point, because he said, no, it still works. And I showed him that, no, it doesn't work. It hides the whole section, period. So just use a local filter. Make sure you click at the section level in here, which at the section level, which automatically you'll assume that one. Create a simple local filter, and game, set, match, you got it. It works. Other questions? I see a few blinking lights, but maybe we're answering those. I've done presentation in the past with breaks where I showed you with master detail how you could do your ranking or could sort based on the subtotal values. So that was in a previous one. That's a secondary part of that, but you saw the big part of it here was more directly the stuff you see going on right here as well. What I didn't do is a conditional formatting here. I could have said, create a rule, call it the section total rule that says if this is greater than 9, make it green, otherwise make the background red. And I could share it with these two cells and they'll be all red or all green along with this. And if I wanted, I could even hide the report. But look at it, a whole new way of laying out your data. And this doesn't have to be a stoplight. You saw the really cool example where I had a pie chart. There was a pie chart instead. It gives me a different alternative way of handling it. Other questions?
Yeah, Michael, there's someone who's just asking if you can share the slides. So I just wanted to let everyone know that we'll be sending out the presentation after it's over. And it'll be on our YouTube channel and our site. So yeah, this whole thing's being recorded. I don't know if, you know, just wanting the slides individually, if that's something we can get out, but the session is being recorded and we'll send you the video.
There's other videos from prior sessions that I've done. And well, again, as I move forward, if anybody out there is, their company's at a point where they might be at least exploring and looking superficially at 4.3, you know, let me know. We could do a future presentation on that. If you're going to start setting it up in a sandbox environment, you definitely want to do some training for that because it's got a whole different look, whole different look. The front end's a little bit similar. But if you can transition, think, how did I do it in 4.2 versus 4.3? It makes it much easier to pick up. But there's a lot of new things, the way things are laid out. So it takes a little bit more. So my recommendation is get comfortable in 4.2 so you know all the features, you know the analysis toolbar, you know a lot of these other secondary things that we've covered. Then when you migrate up, you already know the feature. It's just a matter of what's the little tweak, the little different thing that I have to do in 4.3 versus 4.2. Remember, 4.3 release won't be out till end of this year, early next year. That'll be the 4.3 SP2 release. One we're running, but has some interesting undocumented features as well. So most all of us will be using 4.2 for a long while. Many of you only recently migrated to SP6 or SP7. You're finally taking advantage of, you know, element linking, intra-document linking, and so many of the great features that are available as well. Other questions? check the recording out, check the other recordings that are out there as well, because I've done quite a number of these working with Accelerate. Ann and I have done some webinars on other ones, and the analysis tab, your best friend, is one of many. Give me some ideas for future topics. We try to schedule based on what we think the interest level would be. You're the best ones to tell us that. I'm getting some requests lately for multiple data providers again. How do I bring in multiple queries? How do I bring in Excel? How do I bring in Free and SQL? How do I merge it together? And what are the rules? So if that's something you're hot for, or it's been a while and you really need a refresher, make a request. We would be happy to include it. That seems to be the one, particularly when you get into Excel files and updating. So, but whatever you'd like, we can schedule, give you these little webinars and give you an opportunity to ask questions and see how we can do some of these really cool features. How do we look, Ann? Any others? We fielded all the questions.
Sorry, did we get in a section report, can you have merged dimensions?
The answer is yes, but you would do the merging of the dimensions irrespective of the report block that it is. You're linking them together based on the queries, how you segment it out, as long as you've got the right number of dimensions. If you're linking on year and you're creating different reports, you got to have year in those, and you still have the ability to use the merge dimension option for that as well, the one you're merging on. So it would still be you do all the merging beforehand and then start pulling the pieces into the report, whether it's a vertical table or a master detail. All right, let me pop this back up just for a second and Ann can finish it out. If you need to hit me with any questions, whatever, you've got my email address, you know how to reach me. Many of you are on my list for updates for all that. Don't forget, next week's our advanced reporting. We set it up because many of you requested it. There's some people out there, I'm sure, in a webinar today that are signed up. It's an awesome two half day class. You get spread out a little bit, get a little more time in there. We work you pretty good in there. You do a lot with multiple data providers and merging, and do a lot with advanced calculations and formulas and subqueries. And it's a pretty good course. It is advanced. Hopefully you've got basic and intermediate equivalent experience. And sign up. We've got room for people if anybody else is interested. And if I'll let you take it from there and finish it out.
Yeah, just had a great question from Jim about the 4.3 update session. So we should probably think about maybe scheduling a webinar in a little bit to share everything that's new in 4.3. So I think that's a really good suggestion if you're game for it, Michael.
Yep, absolutely.
Yep. Okay, perfect. And so after the webinar, you'll just get a little evaluation form. And so if you've got any ideas for other webinars you'd like to see, like the 4.3 update or, you know, another topic, please let us know. Also, if you're available or interested in training, either for individuals or for a group, you can let us know there. And we also really value your feedback. We read every single eval that comes in. I share it with Michael, and we really appreciate that. And we also appreciate you guys being here with us today. And I'm going to take back control just for a second.
Yep, okay, there you go. Cool.
Thank you. All right. So hopefully you should see the business objects training screen. Yeah.
Yep. There it is. Yeah.
Perfect. Yeah, so just, you know, after this, if you're interested, if you want to look at some of the outlines for these classes that Michael teaches, we do all these for groups of three or more, and we can customize it to your specifications. But if you're just looking for a class for an individual, let's just say it's you and maybe one other person from your company who needs training. Michael is doing kind of a pop-up advanced web intelligence reporting. We weren't sure we were going to do this, but it just kind of happened. So that's coming up July 20th, 21st. But we still have a couple of spots, and we do like to try to keep the class small so you get a lot of individual attention. And you get Michael and all of his materials. And also half day, if that helps, which I think a lot of people like. So with that, Michael, unless there's anything else, I can go ahead and close this out. And
okay. Thank you all for attending.
Thanks so much, everyone, for attending. And if you have a couple minutes to fill that email out, that would be awesome. So thank you for joining us. I hope everyone has a wonderful day. Bye.